my nose.
Were you lovers?
Yes, but not in a conventional sense.
So, how did you do it?
I caught sight of a large amethyst ring coming straight for my face. I didn't have a chance. I got it square on the bridge of the hill.
Kiss him.
When you kiss, do you keep your eyes open?
Do you want to borrow my sewing machine? Play that record again. Give me a light, will you?
You're not afraid of me, are you?
I don't think so. Perhaps. I ask,
would you like some guacamole?
She said yes. We did up with chips and talked about sex. She confessed her friendship with women were often difficult. Why are you here?
Self-knowledge, that's about it.
I'll tell you what I think of you. I'm not impressed by your belief that everything you do is ordained by a higher order.
Significance. I removed the brain of my husband through his nasal passages, and I remove his entrails through an incision I have made along the foil of his groin. I replace these things each morning before he awakes, and remove them again each night. My husband knows nothing of these practices.
Why are you laughing?
I think there are two kinds of women, those who love stuffed animals and those who hate them.
The pursuit of power is always seen as evil.
Because it occurs in the first love. You can't have both.
She dresses in white. She speaks in black. Her socks are red. She dresses in
red.
She speaks in black. herself. She dresses in white. Herself in black. She dresses in white. She told me on the phone we were entering a new mature phase of our friendship. She said that in order to truly choose your qualities and not let them get the best of you, you've got to give them up, even the good ones, for a time. Luminescence in nature is still a mystery. All that follow is true, I swear.
They made some little cages made of pups and
vines. The eggs themselves were what you were after.
The eggs are luminous even when containing the warm.
The eggs shine softly through the skin of the mother's belly.
Lampyrus noctiluca, the lantern bearer. A curious little animal which, to celebrate the joys of life, kindles a beacon at its tail.
The tail light most commonly issues from the male.
A bright light, much harder to spot, is a scarf of pale scarf of light, draped veil like about the neck of the
feet. Six short legs, dark brown fur, pale pink thorax.
Each body segment marked by two bright spots of red.
A costume like this was never worn by a woman.
A small snail about the size of a cherry is the glowworm's favorite meal.
With conscious consideration, before the glowworms begins to eat, she administers the soporific. Oh. All that follow is true, I swear. We knew from our researches that luminescence is controlled by a respiratory mechanism.
Light itself is a type of oxidation, but oxidation of what nature? No one is sure.
It's a liquid-like powdery material, not known to occur elsewhere in nature.
Difficult to break down chemically, impossible to synthesize.
Something like matter in the force.
Or plasmic state.
Air flowing over this unknown powdery substance regulates the brightness.
Excitement sets the air in motion.
From start to finish, the glowworm's life is one great orgy of light. It was high summer when we dissolved our partnership. We sat on the pebbly beach outside the infamous Burg of Paradise. We shared a basket of olive berries, dark bread, champagne, spiced cheese, gin, garlic, and plums, and sweetened coconut, black beans, more garlic, more gin. Her reconstructed nose had taken 6 weeks to heal. By this time, it formed a perfect patrician line down the center of her face. Soon, she would be leaving, starting a new life. She offered me a pair of glass-based boudoir lamps, which I declined.
I saw it on television. A dozen young men barged into the woman's home to investigate rumors that she was the dreaded Mononongal. The cameras revealed the face of a terrified elderly lady attempting to explain that she was not the Mononongal. She had proof that she herself had been attacked by the demon. She displayed her feet, which were missing several toes.
On the Broad Boulevard, we pause on our way to the station to watch a performance by two men with a goat and a llama. The she-goat is dressed in a bikini top and short half skirt with a rhinestone-studded G-string. Tiny silver bells surround her ankles. She wears a feathered hat. The stunt consists of this. The goat is led up a 3-foot-high step ladder. Slowly, slowly, she climbs to the top, while one man whips the backs of her leg with a leather strap. On the tiny pedestal for a moment, she carefully places all 4 delicate hooves. She climaxes the act by raising one leg a few inches in the air. Even more slowly, she descends. Her trembling makes the ladder unstable. I can see now that she's old. How many times has she been forced to enact this little drama? Hind legs first, slowly, slowly she descends, while the llama is led around by a second man who collects money in a hat. And a third man I hadn't seen before beats a single drum.
Thank you.
I'll speak with that. Formerly he had stupid competitions.
Thank you. Thank you.